Hi, I'm Ellie, vegan brand designer, and let's talk about the curious case of Chris Doe. He's not dead, he's just a really good salesperson. There are a lot of videos about sales on YouTube, right? They are full of tips and psychological tricks. They will teach you how to use reading body language to your advantage. Give the right information at the right time. Say things in a specific way designed to make the sale. And after all, that is the goal, right? Is it though? So who is Chris Doe and what makes him so special? He is, among other things, just a salesperson, right? Well, yes and no. Let's dive in. So Chris is the founder of Blind, a brand strategy design consultancy, and the Futur, an online academy for designers and creatives. He wears many hats, yes, literally, and one of them is that of a salesperson. Now, while it's true that Chris didn't invent the sales techniques I'm about to share with you, he was the first person I saw talking about it and using it and practicing it. Where does that come from? That comes from the Win Without Pitching Manifesto by Blair Enns. So let's start with the traditional way of selling. Now, we all have experience with the traditional way of selling, as we all have been sold to. Remember, they talk about the features, how their product will revolutionize your life, how they are the best in the business, and how you won't find prices better than this, and so on. Now, they could be right, although they're probably just exaggerating a lot. But why do we feel so annoyed? Isn't that weird? But they're just presenting us with possible facts. What is so wrong with that? Presenting, you say. It's always a presentation. There is no conversation. A lot of the times, they don't even ask you if you'll be interested in their products. Or if they do, they ask you like those really dumb questions like, do you like to not die from dehydration? Seriously? Seriously. So as I just triggered you with that little enactment, you know why that doesn't always work. Because it's annoying. And if you as a seller are mostly just annoying people, your conversion rate is gonna be real bad. Now let's talk about what Blair teaches and how Chris implements it. So like Blair Enns wrote, selling when done properly has nothing to do with persuading. It is not our job to talk people into things. The job is to help. Help uncover the real problem. Help come up with the solution. Help going from pain points to clarity. And developing a map to success. Whatever that looks like to the client. And sometimes you might not be able to help. You can't solve all problems, and that is okay, because by being honest and saying, look, you are here, you need to get there, these are your obstacles, I cannot help you with all of them, maybe I can do some of it. What I could also do is direct you to other people so they can help you solve this other portion. Even if you don't get the job now, the important thing is that you're developing rapport. The client will not be paying for the services now, but they will trust you, and when they have the problem that you can solve, they will remember you, because that is a memorable thing that just happened. Who doesn't want the business? Who doesn't want the money? But when you put money before the people, that doesn't work. Or if it does it though? Does it though? And watching the Futur on YouTube, I realized that the goal, like I just said, it's not to get the job, it's to help. And when your goal is to help, all of that anxiety of, I have to get this job, I need this money, I have to get this client, I have to close the deal, all of the anxiety just goes away, because all you're trying to do is understand the problem and see how you can help. There's no urgency, right? When your mindset shifts to helping, you listen more. You add more value. You make a connection that transcends business. It's personal. Because even in a business setting, we're still human. We're still connecting whether we want to or not. So if someone was like, look, I understand your problem. I can't help you. It's not that I don't want to, it's that I can't help you. But I have this network of people that I can direct you to, and they will be able to help you. Is that okay? And you're like, yeah, dude, let's do this. Hell yeah! Thank you. Thank you for being honest. Thank you for caring about me and my business. Thank you. See? Connection. Boom. I say this is the curious case of Chris Doe, even though what I see is him implementing the lessons from Blair Enns. Is that how you pronounce that? I am so sorry if I'm wrong. Win Without Pitching Manifesto, because he was the first person I saw talking about sales like this. All of them, Chris, Blair, and the people at the Futur, made sales seem like the complete opposite of what I always thought of sales, salespeople, sales in itself. Instead of feeling sleazy and gross and kind of just like icky, you know? Because if when you hear sales, you just think, oh, they're pushing me stuff that I don't even need. Like, I don't want to talk to these people. They don't care about them. They just care about money. They opened my eyes to see that when shifting your mindset to helping, everyone wins. The salesperson wins because they're helping. And in any way, they will either build rapport, such a weird word, or they will get the client. And the client wins because no one is pushing them anything. They're just trying to solve the problem that the client has. And isn't that great? That's just great. So if you want to sell better, you know, use the psychological tricks, reading body language and using jargons. Like, don't. Just help. The intention is to help and they will. That's not it. That's not the song. Just help. Okay, thank you for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.